Good afternoon, children. Welcome to physics class. In the last class, we have started sound lesson, right? We have discussed about how the sound travel in solids, liquids, as well as gaseous. What is the speed of sound? What is the velocity of the sound? Okay. So, speed of sound is more in solids than liquids and gaseous. Okay. So, in the same way, velocity of the solids is more than the liquids as well as and gaseous. Sounds are always produced in the form of waveform. Okay, we have three types of waves. What are they? Mechanical wave, longitudinal wave, and transverse wave. Sound travels in the form of longitudinal waves. What is a wave here? It is a disturbance created in the media which is perpendicular to the mean position. Mean position is nothing but where it has started. This wave always travels in the ups and downs, creating some disturbance in the media which is proportional to the sound. Now, according to this wave, what are the characteristics of a wave? What does the wave contain? Okay, so how does the speed of the solids are identified and how does the speed of the lights are? Light is speed of the solids and light liquids are identified now. So here we have different terms. First thing to study about the characteristics of the sound. First thing is wavelength. So we are going to discuss about wavelength, which is denoted by lambda. Next is amplitude, which is denoted by capital A. Time period, T. Frequency, mu. And next last one is the wave velocity, v. Okay. So here, what is wavelength? Length. Wave. Wave disturbance created. Length. What is the length of the wave? Okay. See here. This is a wave, what we are going to discuss about, this is sound wave. So, wave's length is nothing but from, what is the length of the wave with a complete oscillation. Okay. So, here vibrations produced, the oscillations are produced to complete one oscillation. What is the length of one oscillation is called as its wave length, the length of one wave. Okay. So, here it's a lot of ups and downs, that is west end. Throat are there. So here the distance between successive crest or successive throats are called as wave. That means, for example, if we start from here, it moves to first throat and then again to crest. Okay. So these two from A to P is called as wave length. Okay. The length of a single vibration or oscillation is called the wave length. Okay. So if it is starting from here, it makes a break and then it forms one more wave. Yes or no? So again it has reached its position. Here after function of one crest line, one rod. Okay. They are said to be as wave. The distance of one oscillation. Okay. It is called as wavelength, that is from A to E, two successive crests or two successive troughs. That is from A to E is called as wave length. The length of the wave. The distance between two successive crests or two successive troughs. What is crest and trough? The position reached by the wave above the mean position is called as. Yes, this is the mean position. Okay, the maximum distance reached by the wave above the mean position is called as crest, and the maximum distance reached by the wave below the mean position is called as trough. Above the mean position, crest; below the mean position, trough. Clear, everyone? So this is the wave. Next, amplitude. Amplitude is nothing but here we have discussed about crest and trough. The height of the crest from the mean position, okay, this is the mean position. The distance between, the maximum displacement between x, y, the maximum displacement between the wave and the mean position is called as amplitude, that is height of the crest or depth of the trough. It is called as amplitude. Amplitude is denoted by capital A. It is the maximum displacement reached by the wave. Okay, this is the maximum place reached by the wave or not?
okay, it may be either the height of the crest or depth of the throat. Clear? The height of the crest or depth of the throat is called as amplitude, or the maximum displacement reached by the wave is called as amplitude. Next is time period. Here time period is nothing but maximum time taken by the wave to complete one oscillation. Clear everyone? The time period is nothing but the maximum number of how much time is taken to complete one oscillation is called its time period, is denoted by capital T. Next, frequency means how many waves are created in 1 second. Okay, number of waves or number of oscillations created in 1 second is called its frequency. For example, here for 1 second, 1, 2, 2.5. Okay, that means 2.5. So here frequency is nothing but how many waves are created for 1 second. There have been created almost 2.5 waves. So frequency here is 2.5. If there are 4 waves produced like this, okay, then its frequency is 4 per 1 second. Frequency is nothing but number of oscillations created in 1 second. Number of oscillations produced in 1 second, or number of oscillations produced in the required time, is called as time frequency. Frequency can be denoted as 1/T. Okay, so frequency is number of oscillations per 1 second, and these units are hertz. The SI units of frequency are hertz. Okay, hertz. Here in short term we can write as hz. Here frequency once again. So here the number of oscillations produced in 1 second is called as frequency, and time period is the time taken to complete one oscillation is called as time period. Frequency is the number of oscillations produced in 1 second is called as frequency. So here is the relation between time period as well as frequency, that is mu is equal to 1/T. Okay, this is frequency, this is time. So time period is always inversely proportional to the frequency. Clear? Now, what is wave velocity? Means what? What is wave velocity? Velocity is equal to displacement by time, right? Okay, so here wave velocity is the maximum distance traveled by the wave. How much distance has been traveled? Frequency says how many waves are produced per 1 second. Velocity says how much distance the wave has traveled. So here we have a formula. Velocity is equal to distance traveled by the wave, total distance traveled by the wave by time taken. Okay. So velocity is equal to what? Distance is what? Lambda, that is wavelength. Yes. So distance is lambda, and time taken is denoted by t. Now, can I write this as v? Velocity is equal to 1/T into lambda. 1/T into lambda. I am separating lambda as well as t. And what is 1/T here? Mu. Yes or not? Frequency is equal to 1/T. So 1/T, in case of 1/T, I am writing v is equal to mu lambda. So velocity is equal to mu into lambda. Okay. So how we have obtained it? Wave velocity, velocity formula is distance traveled by time, distance traveled by time taken. Distance traveled is how much? The length of the wave, right? So it is lambda, and time taken is t. Time taken is t, no? So here I am separating lambda and t. Instead of lambda, I am writing 1/T into t. That is, v is equal to 1/T into lambda. 1/T is equal to mu. Okay? So v is equal to mu into lambda. This is the wave velocity. These are the characteristics of the wave. First thing is wave length. Okay. The length of the wave, the distance between two surfaces.
crest above the mean position is called as length of the feather is divided by lambda. Amplitude is the height of the crest, or the length of the cloud is called as amplitude, or the maximum displacement reached by the wave is called as amplitude. Next is time period. The time taken to complete one oscillation is called as time period. Only one oscillation here. From here to A to E, how much time is taken here? That is called as time period. Next is frequency mu. It is generated by mu. Frequency is equal as to number of waves produced in number of oscillations produced in 1 second. Okay. So in 1 second here, almost 1.5 waves are produced. So frequency of this wave is 2.5 hertz. Why? Because hertz is nothing but SI units of frequency is hertz. So we can write mu is equal to 1/T, as it defines the number of waves produced in 1 second. Next is wave velocity. Velocity is nothing but speed of the wave, how much distance it has traveled. Okay, to find it, we have a formula: v is equal to distance by time. So what is the distance traveled by the wave? It is denoted by wavelength. Okay, lambda by time taken. Time 1/time taken is equal to mu. 1/time taken is equal to mu. Since the 1/time writing mu into lambda. So velocity of the wave is v is equal to mu lambda. These are the some of the characteristics of the wave. Next, we learn about sonic sounds. So here sonic sounds are nothing but see, all the vibrations will not be producing same amount of frequency. What is frequency again here? Number of oscillations produced per 1 second. Okay, some bodies will be vibrating 20 oscillation. Some will be vibrating even 40,000 times also in 1 second. Clear? That means whatever body it is vibrating 40,000 will be having more vibrations, that is more frequency. Whatever the body is making some sound, it is only 20 times, it is called as less frequency. Did you see grass on the ground? It also vibrates, it also moves front and back. But you are not getting any sound from the grass. Why? Because it is making, its frequency is less than 20. Okay, its frequency is less than 20. That means it vibrates less than 20 times in 1 second. So that sounds could not be heard by us. So whatever the sound is heard by us are called as sonics. We have mainly two types of sonics. One is infrasonic, as well as one more is ultrasonics. So infrasonics are nothing but infrasonics as well as ultrasonics. So here, infrasonic is nothing but the objects which will be vibrating less than 20 times. That means whose frequency is less than 20 hertz, they are called as infrasonics. Okay, and ultrasonics means which will vibrate more than 20,000 hertz. Okay, infrasonics are the objects or oscillations which are made with only 20 oscillations per 1 second. That means the frequency are less than 20 oscillations. That means 20 hertz. The source which makes 20 oscillations are called as infrasonics. Whereas some objects make more than 20,000 oscillations in 1 second. That means its frequency is more than 20,000 hertz. They are called as ultrasonic. As we are human beings, we can listen more than 20 hertz and less than 20,000 hertz. Here grass is making a small amount of sound. No? It moves less than 20 hertz or right, so we cannot hear the sound. Okay, that means this infrasonic, which is less than 20 hertz, is called as infrasonic. We could not hear that which is more than 20,000 hertz, whose frequency is more than 20,000 hertz, we can hear that. Okay, so this is regarding infrasonic as well as ultrasonic. Infrasonic means whose frequency is less than 20 hertz, they are called as infrasonic sounds, and whose frequency is more than 20,000 hertz, they are called as ultrasonic. We could not hear infrasonic as well as ultrasonic. Between the range we can be hearing. That means more than 20 hertz we can listen, as well as less than 20,000 hertz also we can listen. But do you know that elephants can even listen infrasonic? That means they can listen the very low frequency sounds also. Okay, which we could not hear. And dogs can hear ultrasonic sounds also, which are up to 40,000 hertz. Okay, the body is 30,000 hertz we could not hear, but whereas dogs can hear. They have a capacity of only 20,000 hertz. Dogs have a capacity to hear more than 20,000 and less than 40,000. They could hear the sound. Okay, that is the reason sometimes the in the rainy season, though we could not hear any thunder, sometimes dogs will be fearing. Okay, this is due to ultrasonic. As we could not hear ultrasonics, we have lot of fears with this ultrasonics also. Okay, so ultrasonics are mainly applicable in the medical field. See, this ultrasonics can detect some of the defects in our body also. For example, any tissue in the body is damaged, to know whether it is damaged or not, to check that ultrasonics are used. These ultrasonics are used if there is in big machine, if there is any damage in the machine, where it is tear or just crack, then we can use this ultrasonics to repair them. Okay. One more application is that we have learned about pasteurized milk. Yes or no? So whereas here homogenized milk is also there, where in pasteurized milk it is heated to kill the bacteria, but here in homogenized milk the cream is mixed in the bacteria with more amount of sound. It is with ultrasonics, whatever the cream is there in the milk, it is mixed into cream, or fat is there in the milk, it is mixed in the milk itself. So that type of milk is called as homogenized milk. So here that homogenized milk is made by using ultrasonics. This major use of ultrasonic is in the medical field. Okay, and this ultrasonic is also used to weld some of the metal parts. So this is regarding ultrasonics as well as ultrasonics. Human can listen the sound which is whose frequency is more than 20 hertz and less than 20,000 hertz. And remaining, the next class will be discussed.